This is called The Doors to My Mind. I've been raised since a kid in the cradle to be ladylike, sweet and demure, to rely on my elders and betters, and I grow up loved and secure. As a kid I was raised in a convent, and it wasn't that they were unkind, but they told me that school was to teach me to learn, and they locked up the doors to my mind. I felt trapped like a bird in a cold iron cage, so I fled to the rocks and the sea, flew away from that cage of a convent. But the nuns sent their cops after me. They followed, they cornered, they caught me, had me up at a juvenile court. The magistrate said, you're an ungrateful girl, it's approved school that deals with your sword. Now I'd never known what you'd call a real home, even less had I known a real block. So that cooking and sewing and home care, it seemed like a cruel joke. I couldn't take all of their preaching, so off to the city I fled. When you're feeling as lonely as I did, your price is a meal or a bed. And though men were the custom I dealt with, it was me that they clapped in the pen. The man at the bench put the blame square on me, for the laws are made by and for men. When a woman comes out of a prison, life's hard as hell outside. But there's ways to forget all the hurt and the rage, and to grind from the depths to the high. But the high, it was never forever, and always the pain burned back through. When you're feeling as lonely as I did, there seems nothing that no one can do. It was stomach pumps, shrimp, social workers, most of them sold on square lines, never questioning all of the rules they obey, never asking the hows and the whys. One question I'd always been asking was, why should this happen to me? But my sisters help me feel how we all get this deal, that's what they don't want us to see. For the first time I cried and respect now, and the power to change things myself. So we need not be outcasts, my sisters, if we stand up and fight for ourselves.